In this video, I'm going to be driving in MBTA train from Boston, Massachusetts to Providence, Rhode Island. So here's a train. As you can see, the ATP or head end power is on already because there's already power in the train carriages. I guess I better unlock the passenger doors now as we get the cab set up. Just turn the cutout valve in. Turn this lever to lead or dead, because now that this locomotive is in the lead. And we also have to turn this switch to long hood trail. Actually, wait, no, I might be wrong. No, the head and power. So, when I'm driving this train, if any of you guys know, let me know in the comments when I'm driving a train with passenger coaches on it. Should I set this thing to long hood trail or should I set it to feed through? I don't know. I'm just going to keep it on feed through for now. Just going to sit down, turn all these switches on, engine run that will allow the engine to rev up and accelerate. Control pump on, all that stuff on. We'll put the reverser in so it's done. Don't need the step lights on for now. We'll just put the gauge lights on, and we'll turn the. I'm gonna turn the headlights to dim for now, and then I'll turn them up to bright when we're ready to leave the station. The locomotive on my train is still at a low idle, and oh, I'm rambling, I better close the doors now. The locomotive on my train is still at a low idle, but the one next to me is on high idle. I'm just hearing the one next to me. Alright, I think everything's in place, so put the headlights to bright. Put the neutral forward. Brakes. I am just very impressed by these graphics because I guess as a person that, I guess as a guy that for the longest time played Train Simulator Classic, this is, like, I guess because I'm used to Train Simulator Classic, these graphics are like, these graphics here, of course, like, here in Train Sim World are like 10 times better than Train Simulator Classic. I mean, yeah, they have their flaws somewhere, but being used to Train Simulator Classic, these graphics are like 10 times better than Train Simulator Classic. Anyways, gotta keep it slow. Gotta start. We're starting low and slow here. So I guess I gotta say, welcome aboard, MB. Welcome aboard your 735 MBTA train, making all stops to, don't even know the station names, as I should have. I should, that's the driver. Stoughton. So yeah, I guess I should say, attention passengers, welcome aboard. This is your driver speaking. Welcome aboard your 740 train, now 740 train, to making all stops to Stoughton. On behalf of MBTA and the operating crew, we'd like to thank you for traveling with us. Boston Back Bay Station is the first station stop. Boston Back Bay. Here we are. And I also just realized, before I started moving, I should have went to the cab car and turned on the marker lights, so the train shows red lights at the back, like it's supposed to. I'll do that when I get to Back Bay Station, hopefully before anybody notices. I didn't see any conductor on board this train, so I guess I'll just do the announcements myself. Arriving at Boston Back Bay Station. Those of you exiting at Boston Back Bay Station, please grab all your personal belongings before leaving the train. Thank you for traveling MBTA, and we hope to see you next time. Bring this to a stop. Yeah, I'll bring this to a stop. Before I forget, I'm gonna go to the back of the train and turn on the marker lights so they're showing. to make sure they're showing red lights. Passenger cars. Hi, passengers. Don't mind me. I'm just wandering in the back of the train. Well, the brakes. Don't worry, passengers. The brakes are on, so the train. Hopefully, the train won't go anywhere. Well, the driver is walking around. There we go. I better get back to the front of the train to lock doors. Stand clear of the closing doors, please, or whatever they say on the MBTA, if they say anything. Gotta make sure this needle doesn't go into the red here, so it doesn't hurt the engine. just walking around the train. I'm just sitting in this seat. And we are at our max speed, so I guess I better pull back on the throttle. And this train does not stop. And apparently the Stoughton line train does not stop at Forest Hills. Apparently the Stoughton line train apparently does not stop at Rugley's or Stoughton or Forest Hills station. Here we are. There we go. I just turned down the desktop audio so you can hear my voice a bit better. Sometimes for fun, I like to go to the free camera and watch my train go past one of the stations for speed. will start to slow down here. And by the way, it doesn't really make sense that the MBTA only has diesel locomotives, just because of a few parts of the line that can only be operated by diesel trains. I mean, it doesn't really make sense that the MBTA only has diesel locomotives, just because a few little parts of the line can only be serviced by diesel locomotives, even though there are locomotive brands in America that can switch from diesel mode to electric overhead wire mode. It would make perfect sense for the MBTA to have those kind of locomotives instead of just the diesel ones, but oh well. Seeing as most of the MBTA routes have overhead wires, well, I mean this route anyways. This route anyways, most of the route has overhead wires, so it would make sense that the MBTA would have one of those locomotives where on this part of the route it can run on electric mode, and then on the other part of the route the little section that goes down to Stoughton the locomotive can switch to diesel mode. That would make a lot of sense. But anyways, it's still very interesting. And this route is still quite interesting to explore. And here's a look at my train from the outside. Right, the next station will be Canton Junction. Oh, we got a yellow signal coming up soon, which means we can only go as fast as 45 miles per hour, so I guess I better prepare for that. better slow down to 20 miles an hour, because that's all the speed they want going in this part. And here we are at Canton Junction Station. Canton Center will be our next stop. Canton Center. Very nice trees. Very nice area here. I guess we're... Really, it's quite an interesting dynamic. It feels very realistic going... The train leaving the big city, and now we're in the quiet little countryside. Now going to Canton Center. Okay, the station's literally right up there. Since we're here in the country, probably should be blowing our horn a lot more. Alright, here we have all the passengers getting on the train. This is the high platform for wheelchairs and that. And then we have the low height platform where all the trap doors open up and the stairs, and you can use the stairs. Alright, let's close the doors now. See, these are the low platform doors, so that's why they have that's why the trap doors come up, so people can go up and down the stairs. And our next and final stop will be Stoughton. Stoughton. And now it's only 10 miles an hour.
Thank you.